My name is Vishal Dalvi, one of the board of trustees of the ETMA. Just to tell about myself, I'm a BE MBA, CMT level 2 candidate and international CF level 2 candidate. Before my engineering, I was working in Infosys for 2 years. Post that, I worked with Competence for some time, with Anand Reddy for some time. Then few opportunities led me start my own venture named Waves Capital. We are basically into our own advisory and trading. For HNIs, also teach technical analysis. We have a research report Sabat which gets spread across India. Why I'm here is basically Mr. Sushil Kedia is attending some examination basically. That's why he's expected to come around half an hour or 1 hour late. So, and he'll be there, he might fly to Delhi, so possibly he might not come also because of the inauguration of the ATMA and Delhi Stock Exchange. Briefly, let me just introduce to our speaker today. Mr. Vishal Markhan is a CMD and Master in Finance. He is the head of trainer at the Markhan News and is also a visiting faculty at the BEC Training Institute and also teaches technical analysis and many management institutes and also corporates. He gives advisory services on trading strategies and investment strategies to a lot of HNIs at Markhan News. And he regularly appears on the business channels for his news. His topic today, momentum, I hope everybody is, every trader and analyst who knows everything about RSI and tries to implement. There is no trader I know who doesn't use RSI. Maybe today Vishal will get some more detailed aspects of how we can use not only RSI but other moment indicators. And it will be a delight for all of us to listen to him today. So I welcome Vishal to come across and start the session.
Thanks, Vishal. Myself, Vishal Markhan. As he introduced, I am into technical analysis. I started trading since the age I was 16 years old, so it is almost now 16 years. So it's now because I'm now 32. Have done all the blunders which a technical analyst or a trader can do in the market, and then learned the right way of trading. I've been teaching technical analysis since last 4 years at various management institutes, corporates, BSC, and at my own institute. Let's look at a very basic tool which we, as he said, and everybody uses RSI. Almost all technical analysts. It's a very popular and most commonly widely used tool. Relative strength index, RSI. Conventional usage. How generally people use RSI? As a layman, if he understands only RSI, then the first thing he'll come to know is the most popular. It compares price versus itself. Plotted along a scale of 0 to 100. It's a banded oscillator, so it trades between 0 to 100. Default setting is 14 RSI. You have to use 14 period. 70 is overbought and 30 is oversold. So this is what a basic RSI criteria is, how we use RSI, right? This 70 overbought, 30 oversold. Same thing. And next thing which we use in RSI is RSI divergence. When price makes a new high or a new low versus RSI does not make a new high or a new low, then we have a divergence which is called positive divergence or a negative divergence, right? Divergence between indicator and price moves signals of trend exhaustion. When a divergence appears, we assume that the trend is over or nearing its end because momentum is not going along with the price, or momentum is lowering down or slowing down compared to price. Divergence signals needs to be confirmed with trend reversal signals like trend line, moving average, or retracement, or price itself, right? So this is what we use, or a basic person who knows RSI will use all these things, right? But as per my experience, I've been using this since last 10 years. Initially, this all things used to make money. I don't think nowadays, if you use divergence, or if you use 70 or 40, 70, 30 as overbought and oversold, you'll make a single rupee out of it. If you look at right now silver chart, If you look at daily, monthly and weekly, even any time frame chart, it is all RSI around 90 or 85 plus and there is no stopping to it. If you are considered 70 as overbought or 75 as overbought or 80 as overbought and sold silver or shorted silver, what would be the result? Right, so the normal conventional use nowadays, because more and more people follow, the same thing will not apply or same thing will not be useful, right? So we look at a different perspective of using RSI. Now most of the people here are CMT level 2, 3, so they might be knowing this, but this forum is specially for people who want to get into technical analysis, right? Who want to get into CMT, right? So those people who are already CMT, they can correct me if I'm wrong, going anywhere wrong, because they are already using these tools. But for those who are new, they can always get some insight out of it. Okay. This is what we say is divergence only. When price makes a new high, RSI does not make a new high. It is called negative divergence. It appears in an uptrend and it is appearing against the trend. So we are into an uptrend and we are getting a negative divergence, right? And the same thing, when price makes a new low versus RSI does not make a new low, it appears in a downtrend, it is a positive divergence. Again, it is appearing against the trend, right? So divergence appear against the trend, they signal for reversal in the trend, right? So this is all conventional uses. Now, this is all negative divergence, positive divergence. Now we come to the next part, how RSI I use, or the unconventional use of RSI. First is the range shift behavior, then there are reverse divergences, then there is trend lines on RSI, and then there is support resistance on RSI. Okay, so first look at the range shift behavior of RSI. What do you mean by range shift? Instead of using 70-30, we will not be using 70-30 anywhere. Okay, we'll be using other numbers. If the market is in an uptrend, it is generally observed that it follows a range of 40 to 80. Till the time RSI does not go below 40, it is not supposed to be bearish. And if it's trading within 40-80, it is still into a bull market or a bear or an uptrend. If it is very strong market, then it will not even go below 60. Like, it will follow a range of 60 to 80. Okay, in a downtrend, a stock follows a range of 65 to 20. It will not go above 65 if the market is bearish. Or in some cases 60. 60 and 65 are interchangeable. Some stocks follow 60, some stocks follow 65.